Don't superimpose your idea of what a pull looks like on somebody with goofy anthropometry. Now, let's look at a couple of examples. If we've got a guy like you see all the time with short back, long legs, and short arms, what can you do about that? Not a damn thing. He's just a shitty deadlifter. I can't help him. He's built wrong. Not everybody gets to be a good deadlifter. But by the same token, you can't stuff him into a position that's different than he can assume. Okay? If you've got a guy with a long torso and short legs, he could be nice and upright and make you happy in terms of that nice vertical back. But by the same token, if he bends over even a little bit too much, that real, real long lever arm is a big disadvantage for him. You know, he has to be real upright because the minute he bends over a little bit, he's got a long grip on that wrench. Most people of normal proportions will look like that when they deadlift. Okay, we have got a fairly diverse group in here today, and we will get to see a lot of different correct deadlifts. But correct deadlifts don't look a certain way. Correct deadlifts satisfy the criteria. Okay? Criteria are the torso must be in extension, the back must be in kyphotic and lordotic extension, locked solid. The arms must be straight. The bar must be over the middle of the foot. And the scapulas must be over the bar. Whatever they look like, when those conditions are satisfied, will be correct for that individual. And I think you'll find that people don't deviate very much from that rule anytime they pull off the floor.